Now we are going to see the topic called acid rain. Acid rain is one of the important topic given in our fourth chapter. Everyone, we know what is called acid rain. So here, what is the definition of acid rain is the precipitation of carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide and nitrous oxide gases as pollutant in water. That is called acid rain. Everyone, we know that normal rainwater is always slightly acidic in nature. Why it is acidic in nature means because due to the presence of carbon dioxide in atmosphere. So that's why the normal rainwater is acidic in nature. Suppose in our atmosphere, instead of carbon dioxide, suppose SO2 and NO2, if it is present in our atmosphere, means so the pH of rainwater is further get decreased. We have 3 pH range. pH, if it is 7, means that is called neutral. More than 7 means it is called as basic, and below 7 means it is called as acidic. Normally rainwater is slightly acidic in nature because due to the presence of CO2 gas. Suppose SO2 and NO2, if it is present in water, means the pH get decreased, which is lies in between 1 to 2 range. This type of precipitation of water is called acid rain or acid. Going to discuss now. The acid rain is mainly formed, already we have discussed the 3 important gases called CO2, NO2 and SO2. So these are all the gases is mainly responsible for formation of this acid rain. Here acid rain means presence of excessive acid in rainwater. Presence of excessive acid called sulfuric acid and nitric acid, which is responsible for acid rain. Suppose these are all the acid is present in excess amount in water, means that is called acid rain. Now let us see how this type of acid get formed in rainwater. Here we can see from this image, we can see in our atmosphere it's contain lot of factories and industries and vehicles. So this type of industries, here we can see, which release a lot of SO2 and NO2 as a pollutant into the atmosphere. So here this type of pollutant, when these gases react with water vapor, this type of pollutant are mixed with the water vapor. Here we can see this SO2 and NO2, these which are released from industrial emission and vehicular emission. So this type of gases which is mixed with the water and it forms the acid called H2SO4, which is known as sulfuric acid, and HNO3, which is known as nitric acid. So when these gases react with water vapor in the atmosphere, they form acid. That is already I have explained you, that is H2SO4 and HNO3, and move towards the earth acid rain through rainwater. So here this is the formation of acid rain. So due to the presence of acid rain, we may affect so many side effects, which is not only human beings, which acid rain affect human beings and aquatic animals and terrestrial, and which is on building also. So next we are going to see what are the effects of acid rain. The first effect of acid rain is which affects the human beings. Human beings, which first point, destroy life. Destroy life, the sense which affect the nervous system, respiratory and digestive system. The second one is causes premature death from heart and lung disorders. So these are the main effect of acid rain on human beings. The second one is on building. What are the effect of acid rain on building? building the mainly effect of acid rain is which causes corrosion. Taj Mahal in Agra is mainly corroded due to the effect of acid rain. Not only Taj Mahal, so many houses, statues, bridges and metals which is also affected due to the acid rain. The last effect is on terrestrial and lake ecosystem. Terrestrial and lake ecosystem are already we have studied from the first topic. Terrestrial means which is related to land and lake ecosystem means which is related to water. So the effects of acid rain which may causes effect both terrestrial as well as the lake ecosystem. Here the first point which reduce the photosynthesis. Reduce the rate of photosynthesis. We know that photosynthesis essential for all aquatic as well as terrestrial plants. So this photosynthesis which gets decreases means automatically the fish, crab, all the population get reduced. So this is the reduces rate of photosynthesis and growth of crops and fish population. Finally, which is also get reduced the biomass production. So these are all the main effects of acid. The last one is control measure of acid rain. So this much of effect which is having acid rain. Now we are going to see what are the control measures of acid rain. First method is clean combustion technologies. We have to use the clean combustion technology, then only we can avoid this type of formation of acid rain. The other one is using pollution control equipments. We have to apply the equipments which is free to avoid the pollution. This type of equipments we need to manufacture and we need to apply in industries. The third one is replacement of coal by natural gases. Coal is mainly which produce lot of gases, carbon dioxide, SO2 and NO2 etc. In order to avoid this type of releasing of these gases, you have to replace coal by natural gases. That is also one of the important control measure. The last control measure is liming of lakes and soil should be done. So in order to liming, we can avoid this type of formation of acid rain. Thank you.